Hello friends, in previous lecture we have seen the introductory part of sedimentation. In that we have seen objective of sedimentation, principle of sedimentation, factors affecting sedimentation, types of settling and different types of settling tank. In this lecture we are going to study details regarding various types of settling tank or sedimentation tank. That is fill and draw type of sedimentation tank, continuous flow type of sedimentation tank, circular tank and the hopper bottom type of tank. So starting with fill and draw type of sedimentation tank. In case of fill and draw type of sedimentation tank, wastewater is stored for some time in the tank after it is completely filled. The time may be 24 hours. In that time, the suspended particles are settled at the bottom of the tank. After 24 hours, the water is discharged through the outlet. Then, settled particles are removed. This removal action requires about 6 to 12 hours. So, one complete action of sedimentation requires 30 to 40 hours in case of fill and draw type of tank. And hence, when we are using fill and draw type of sedimentation tank, one standby unit we have to construct. Now, this is the figure which shows plan and section of fill and draw type of sedimentation tank. So, this is the inlet through which wastewater is coming to this sedimentation tank. At that time, the outlet wall is closed. When wastewater is filled for its full capacity, it is detained for 24 hours. And in this detention period, the different impurities will settle at the bottom of this sedimentation tank. And then that impurities are taken from the bottom and the clear sewage is taken through this outlet. Next one, continuous flow type of sedimentation tank. In this type of tank, wastewater is not allowed to rest, but it flows continuously. The flow always takes place, but with a small velocity. During this flow or during this small velocity, suspended particles settle at the bottom of the tank. The flow may be either in horizontal direction or it may be in vertical direction. So in this figure, the rectangular continuous flow type of sedimentation tank is shown. This is a cross section. So through this pipe, the wastewater first enters into inlet zone. And then through this opening, the wastewater is applied to the settling zone. And in this zone, the settlement of particles takes place due to the lesser velocity. And then the outlet zone is there. Through this outlet zone, the remaining particles and clear water or wastewater flows through this outlet pipe. The next one, a circular sedimentation tank. Circular sedimentation tanks are mostly preferred for continuous flow type of sedimentation. In this case, the incoming wastewater is sent through central pipe of the tank and it flows radially. In this tank, the mechanical sludge scrappers are provided to collect the sludge, and collected sludge is carried through sludge pipe provided at the bottom of the tank. But circular tanks are uneconomical as compared to rectangular tank, but they have high clarification efficiency or more sedimentation efficiency. So this is the circular type of sedimentation tank. So here there is a pipe, through which pipe the wastewater is applied over this area of sedimentation tank. Means the wastewater flows radially like this, and in this flow of wastewater, the settlement of different sediment takes place at the bottom of sedimentation tank. Then here one channel is constructed. Through this channel, the treated, or we can say clean, wastewater is collected, and whatever the settled sediments are there, that are taken out the pipe which is provided at the bottom of this tank. Then hopper bottom type of sedimentation tank. In case of hopper bottom type of sedimentation tank, a deflector box is located or provided at the top. So this deflector box deflects the incoming sewage or wastewater, and then this wastewater flows in downward direction. Sludge is collected at the bottom and is disposed through the sludge pipe. So this is the hopper bottom type of tank. The bottom is reduced in size, that's why it is called as hopper type of sedimentation tank. Now here this is a sewage pipe which carries the wastewater to this hopper bottom type of tank, and here there is a deflector box. This deflector box send the wastewater to this particular tank, or it spreads the wastewater in this particular tank. So wastewater is coming first downward, and then it flows in upward direction, and then whatever the impurities are there, that may try to settle at the bottom of this hopper bottom tank. Then here there is a pipe. Through this pipe, the clear wastewater is taken out, and whatever the settled sludge is there, that settled sludge is pumped through this pipe and taken out of the hopper bottom type of tank. Then next, based upon the location, there are two types of sedimentation tank. First one is called as primary sedimentation tank, and second one is called as secondary sedimentation tank. So we will see these two tanks in short. Primary sedimentation tank is a normal sedimentation tank in which water or wastewater is stored at a rest for some time, and sludge collected at bottom and oily matter collected at top are removed periodically. After primary sedimentation, the wastewater is sent to the secondary treatment or for the biological treatment. Then second type of tank, secondary sedimentation tank. After biological treatment, or we can say secondary treatment, the wastewater enters into the secondary sedimentation tank, in which suspended particles along with bacteria and microbes are get settled at the bottom of this secondary sedimentation tank. And then as the sludge consists of more number of bacteria, that sludge is sent for the aerobic filters to maintain the high concentration of microbes in aerobic filter. So this is regarding details of different types of filter. Thank you.